Happy New Year and welcome to Life Plus. It's the world's only rollerblading DVD magazine. We're about 10 miles outside of Sin City, USA, Las Vegas, Nevada, where we're going to be hosting this issue of Life Plus and hopefully trying to win a little bit of money on the side. This is the sixth issue in the Life Plus series, so we've decided to roll the dice this time and go for broke. As always, we're going to bring you the best of what rollerblading has to offer, but be prepared for a few surprises this time. With that warning, get ready. This is Life Plus. Hold on a second. You mean to tell me we're starting this issue with a spotlight profile? But don't we usually save that for the end of the DVD? Are you sure this is gonna work? Well, okay, I guess we'll give it a try. Up next is Ron Copeland out of Ohio. Check him out.
And when I first put on skates and realized that I could slide across the emptiness of this consumer culture, across the brains of the insane people who think that life is learned in a classroom, that life is lived watching real TV. When I first put on skates and felt that adrenaline dance, time stop, motion blur, athletic, aesthetic. When I first put on skates and felt that pixie dust drip off my toes while I floated over the ground as if by magic. That's when I knew that whatever we do, there's a wheel always spinning underneath us.
Welcome back. We've got a big section coming up. Starts off with a trip all the way across the country to North Carolina, and I'll tell you about the rest after I slip into something a little more comfortable. Ah, much better. After North Carolina, we're going to come back to this side of the country and check in with rollerblading legend Eric Burke and find out what he's been up to lately. Then we go back up north to NorCal for a freeform section featuring a lot of your favorite riders.
Yo, before we jump the section off, we gotta get some good music to keep the energy flowing. We're gonna go check out Goodwill and see if we can find anything for the low low. Let's go.
Hold on.
Oh, he's dead?
Yeah, it's dark now.
We're gonna have a real
show tonight. It's gonna be a little different from the way most of the shows have gone down. We're gonna do everything with our heart and do it good. Yeah. We'll be recording the live.
We're about to go to Almaro Middle School. It's an old school spot we used to skate back in the day. They tore down some of the stuff and built new stuff, so it's a hot spot. Check it out. And we needed a ledge spot pretty bad, and then Kenny and Joe one late night went and painted one of the ledges, and ever since then it's been slick enough for us to wax it and just get the shit out of it.
Listen to the bass, man. Go get the same groovy.
Yo, we're at third spot, yo, post office fucking park ledge. It's pretty exclusive right about now. We're just chilling, we got a lot of heads out here, a lot of the young guys out here. A lot of the old guys out here. There's a football game going on. Hoping we don't got no static, no beef. So we're just chilling. I'm ready now to go. Skating the launch spot, infamous Charlotte spot. Some hot stuff was going down. Been a long day of skating. We've hit four spots up. We tried to go skate the fifth spot and got kicked out. About to go check out one more spot and wrap it up.
This is the name of the state in America. It's called North Carolina. It's kind of a country kind of place.
Day, so you know what I'm saying, we're just gonna call it a day on all this hard skating. Yo, thanks to James Ricci for coming out. Thanks to everybody at Life Plus. Peace.
Hey, I'm Eric Burke. I'm living here in Reno, Nevada. I've been working on mural projects since I got home, such as this one behind me. and been trying to repaint the whole town and make the public space a lot more important. They have a big graffiti problem, I guess, in Reno, and they think every time they see someone with a spray can that they're making graffiti. So we're working on a mural. We've been working on it for 2 weeks now, and this is our first run-in. Probably won't be the last. And they just love me because I have a background in graffiti. They're running my name right now. They're finding all sorts of good little tidbits to jump on. The concept here is to paint a mural. They wanted like children types thing to it. We're trying to paint something the kids would do, so we came with this tug-of-war idea. And so it got kind of like fucking super out of control, and now it's not really about kids, but it's a tug-of-war between nature and industry and, I don't know, the modern-day world. And so we got all these businessmen and robots and shit pulling this one rope on the one side, and then the other side is just all these like fruity characters and animals and whatnot. And so, I don't know, we're just trying to adapt to the length of the wall here. We get to throw in lots of bums and homeless people over here on the modern day society side. Pat Lennon's over there with my brother, chilling, smoking, not doing any work at all. It's got fun little subliminal stuff in it. So I don't know how many I've painted around Reno. Not that many, not yet. But I want to just keep going because it's so addictive. But just like this alleyway, I'm trying to take over this whole alleyway. So the plan is, I painted one down there at May 10 Music. That was the first thing I did once I got back to town. And it was the first one, it went pretty good. It was just fun because it's so big and I got to paint a bicyclist. I hell like bicycles, so I'm trying to like link this whole alleyway, and then we took over the alleyway across the street behind Romantic Sensations. I don't know, there's probably like 5 or 6, maybe 7 things running around town right now. I've been trying to repaint the whole town and make the public space a lot more important. So people get outside and enjoy stuff. Kind of something rollerbladers have been doing all along, but just a new aspect of seeing the environment. So I'm sure we're gonna have something good come out of this. I'm gonna go find out what happened. Right. But Life Plus forever.
We'll be right back.
Well, as you can see, my luck's been running pretty low, and I'm almost completely out of money. But I'm not out yet, and your luck hasn't changed. There's still plenty more Life Plus coming up.
It's the fan. Are you gonna stand and fight like a man? Will you be as hard as you say you are? Are you gonna run and go get your body gone? What you gonna do when shit hits the fan? Are you gonna stand and fight like a man? And show us you're as hard as you say you are. Are you gonna run and go get your
Okay, thanks guys. Wow, you know where I'm from, we call that Southern hospitality. You see, I was born and raised in Dallas, Texas, where there's a little skate park called Eisenberg's that hosts an annual contest called the Hoedown. It attracts all the best skaters, and this year, Life Plus cameras were there to cover all the action. And they had total access thanks to my connections. While you check out this section, I'm gonna go look for another casino.
There has been a fire reported on your floor. There has been a fire.
Hey, this is Chris Happy here. I'm a Drew filming for Life Plus. I just got my first pair of prototypes of my pro skate. These are the first couple days that I skated them. I was with Drew and we filmed it to share it with you guys. Here's what we got.
To all this new found fire.
I've been skating for about 8 years now. About four of those years, I've been skating for Remedy. This is the first time that I've had a pro anything really, let alone a pro skate. Cousin and I have been working on it for a while. I'm really excited with how they turned out, and I've been getting good feedback from my friends with how they look. That's pretty much it. They should be in store soon. If you get a chance, check them out and try and go back to a hard band skate after skating them for a little while, and that's about it. I'll see you guys later.
Well, I think I finally found a place at the casino where I can't lose. Well, after this next commercial break, we've got something really exciting lined up for you. It's a follow-up to a profile we had back in Life Plus Issue 3 of Kai and Anders Carlson Wee, who you might remember were skating in the woods. That by itself was some of the most unique footage ever captured of rollerbladers, but from what I understand, this new footage blows the old footage away.
Hi, my name's Anders.
And I'm Kai.
That's pretty good.
Last year we went to a camp in the mountains for a week and filmed ourselves skating in the woods.
This year we went back to Holden Village, but stayed all summer volunteering in the kitchen.
We didn't really go there to skate so much as to experience something different, to change our perspective.
It's hard to read things that are written, you know?
It is.
And like,
this line isn't very good.
No, I know. I was just trying to like say, throw something out. We said better stuff like when we were just talking.
Well, we intentionally went somewhere that had, we're skating where we came from.
Right.
So we'd have to experience that and grow from that.
You're gonna have to appreciate the things that you did have, or maybe learn to not appreciate them. You're gonna value it in a different way. What you think skating is, you know? Because it takes you out of that, and it's not concrete, you know? It bends, like, it moves. Like, your idea of what skating is just because that's all you've experienced right now. Rollerblading is so young that so little has been tried. To see what's possible, sometimes you have to get out of the frame of mind that you're working in.
Hey.
the power that exists beyond our imagination, you know, beyond our control. These huge mountains and rivers and life that just goes on without our cars and without our money and without our jobs and our educations and these things we think are so important. This whole world goes on without that. And it's a beautiful thing to witness, you know.
So I written and so I say, bring the moon is on its way.
None of you. Everybody has a frame of mind that they work from, that encompasses their understanding of the world. Sometimes you have to get outside of those borders. Sometimes you have to step outside of that frame in order to see things in a new way.
Arlo. Arlo. Tell them about part two.
Okay. Well, if you can handle it, apparently there's a part two to Framework of Perspective that's in the screen zine. But don't go anywhere just yet, because there's a whole lot more Life Plus coming up. Back in June of 2003, 5050 released their first ever team video, along with Life Plus staff member V. Needless to say, the video turned out pretty amazing, but what's even more amazing is that 5050 included a single golden ticket in one of those DVDs, and the lucky winner got the chance to spend a day with skate legend John Julio. Well, the lucky winner was a kid named Adam from Portland, so V grabbed his camera and followed along with John Julio, and this is the footage they brought back. And while you check out that footage, I'm gonna check out this casino.
Adam Green Halley, I'm the golden ticket winner. Bought the 5050 Juice video and just opened it up, and then there's a little yellow golden ticket thing. And so now John and V are up here, and I'm gonna take around Portland, show them what we're about.
John needed some new skates before we sessioned, so we stopped by Skate House to get them hooked up. For the first spot, we went to some chill ledges to get warmed up. Next, we went to a drop rail that John had seen on the way to my house.
You think the head has it?
The head is up there. His head's on top of it. I think he's got it.
I never skated these rails, but we laid down some tricks before the fuzz showed up. To Hillsborough Skate Park and had some fun. Hiding, let down some tricks and got to see an aspiring pimp. Next, we went to these steep down ledges in Beaverton and laid some tricks.
That's the wall ride, soul grind, something, I don't know, to Royale.
Hey, Plant Royale.
Some trick. Spots. We skated, had a pretty good day, sweated, had some good skating. Just want to say thanks to John right here. And 50-50, Lawrence Ingram, Jess D, V, Life Plus. That's a wrap.
I'm down to my last dollar, and you're down to the very last section of this issue. I may give it one more go, and I'm gonna hope that Lady Luck shines down on me. And speaking of Lady Luck, I can't think of a better time to introduce the very first female ever profiled in a Life Plus DVD. Introducing the new Queen of Street, Shannon Rogers.
What's going on?
Where is it? Oh my gosh.
Get out. Yeah? You like that ish?
Pussy good. Well, come on. Well, come on.
Break in Vegas. I better go home while I've still got something to show for it. If you like what you've seen in this issue of Life Plus, be sure to check out the Life Plus e-store at www.life-plus.tv. We hope you had a good time rolling with us this issue. Be sure to keep a lookout for Lucky Issue number 7 coming out this spring. And as always, we'd like to thank the sponsors, the skaters, and most importantly, you for making Life Plus possible. This has been Life Plus issue number 6 from Las Vegas, Nevada. My name is Arlo Eisenberg, and I'll see you next time.
Stop it now. Pump it, pump it.
Remember one thing, skating is from the heart. And if you're a skater, always skate from the heart. It doesn't matter the richest, the poorest. It doesn't matter the pros, the amateurs. Only thing matters is what's on the bottom of your feet and how you represent it. I love it, it loves you, so love it, one love, dreadlocks.
Yeah, yeah.